the most full-send thing that any one of us can do is to take up our cross and follow Jesus. And there's going to be moments where you have to say, I'm going to do it even though I don't want to do it. I'm going to go even though I don't want to go. I'm going to be uncomfortable even though I don't want to be uncomfortable. God is saying, I want to use you in a greater way than you could think or comprehend. Faithfulness in the kingdom of God is not just sitting on what you have. Faithfulness is marked in the Word of God by taking what God has given you for His kingdom and building upon that.
When I think about the Evangel family and all the different people that are a part of it, all the different lives that were impacted over this last year,
yeah.
I think about all those people across campuses, across the region, and God is working in every heart.
Mm-hmm.
And different people are at different spots in their walk with Jesus. And as we've thought about this year, our hope and our goal for the church that I believe God has put in our hearts,
yes.
is that we would all live inside out, that our lives following Jesus, mm-hmm. would be out of the overflow of a healthy heart.
I am full of hope and expectation that people are gonna find freedom this year, that you're gonna step into even a depth of knowing your Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, as your friend, but that people are gonna stop, like we talked about a couple weeks ago, cleaning the outside of the cup and allowing the Holy Spirit to come and cleanse them from the inside out.
But one of the things that we're really excited about this year is what takes place in people's lives when they know Jesus, they've been baptized, they've taken those steps of obedience, they're involved in community with other believers.
In regards to discovering your purpose, we're going to be launching something called Heart and Soul, which really is going to be for anyone and everyone, but particularly those where you're maybe wanting to get on a dream team and you're wanting to serve and find your purpose. We saw, as those that call Evangel home, kind of a part that was missing was really a commissioning into serving, because it's not just filling, you're not just filling up a spot. You're not just standing at a door. You're not just filling a coffee cup. You have a part in the body of Christ. And there is a part to commissioning you into that role that God designed you for. And so we're just so excited for what God's gonna do through Heart and Soul. More information to come, but I'm so excited.
We are just believing God that 2024 is going to be a year where God's going to shake it up in people's lives,
yes.
and people are going to begin to live inside out. And even if things get shaky on the outside or God starts challenging us on the inside, we know the most level path for our feet is to walk in the things of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And no matter what else happens, like, we will stand firm, we will be on the right path. And that all starts in our hearts. And so we're gonna get after the heart this year and believe that as God transforms us from the inside out, it's gonna make all the difference in our lives and in the lives of people around us.
You know, for most of our beginning of our marriage, if you looked at us from the outside, we were Facebook perfect. We were, you know, the American dream. On the inside, though, it was a completely different story. The guilt and shame that were inside of me for things that I have done were transforming me into what Melody referred to as Dale 2.0. My belief system and what I was always concentrated on, focused on, was my identity was tied up in one thing, and that was my career. I am going to be defined by this. This is going to be my legacy. This is who I am. And anybody talked to me about connect groups or any kind of group thing or anything like that, I was like, that is for weak men. That is for men that aren't disciplined. That is for men that have no focus. That's for men that have no drive. That's for men with no testosterone. I mean, I go down the whole list. And I don't want to be associated with that because I don't want to have any kind of sign of weakness. I just kept going down and down, and all of a sudden, I had my phone with me, and I got a text message, and it was from two guys in my Alpha group. And it was the first time I ever felt seen, noticed, loved by someone other than my wife. I know it was those guys that really turned the corner for me
mentally.
And the prayers that was happening. And when Melody came in after that and I told her what happened, she said, there's a lot of people out there that are praying for you. That just blew my mind, because I'm still dealing with the shame and guilt. And I'm thinking, these guys are wasting their prayers on somebody that doesn't deserve this. I am not worthy. I'm a very, very bad person. I don't know. Now I totally embrace it, which is something. Again, connect groups? No, you don't do connect groups. That's a sign of weakness. Now I'm in five. Prayer team? That's crazy talk. And now I look forward to it. I love being on it. I love the people that are on the prayer team. When you have God come into your life in such a way and transform you and forgive you and give you that redemption that you need, it's transformational.
Unique 2023 was one that I definitely will not forget, as this whole auditorium was packed with women who truly came to seek the Lord and have an encounter with him. And we saw that the Lord showed up and worked and moved in their lives in ways that we could have never imagined. And we saw women come forward to be prayed over. And the front of the stage was just full of women responding to God all throughout conference. We saw women, 14 women specifically, take their next step in obedience and following Jesus by being water baptized at conference, surrounded by a sisterhood of women cheering them on. And for the first time ever, we launched a custom Connect group study that tied into the theme of conference. And we saw over 200 women join a Connect group and grow in their faith together in community. And 2023 was great, but I know God has so much in store and so much planned for Conference 2024 Masterpiece. And as we as a church dig in to Inside Out and ask God, what is inside of me that you want to grow, that you want to even prune, that you want to grow in the likeness of Christ, I believe women are gonna come to conference and they're gonna have an encounter. It's not an event, it's an encounter with the living God, and that they're gonna come into the knowledge and the beauty of the masterpiece that God designed them to be. And God is aligning all the details already, all the little things, but I cannot wait for Conference 2024.
In creation, God painted the universe. Precious design for humanity, knitting together every part of you. All to reflect his glory and his beauty. Not to be hidden, but to shine his love that endures forever. To the ends of the earth.
There are over 100 villages in Alaska without a consistent gospel witness.
This has allowed darkness to go unchecked. It has allowed hurt to grow amongst my people for generations. The issue has not been the darkness, but the willingness of those who carry the light to go into the darkness, to brave isolation and the challenges of rural and remote life.
Over the years, hundreds have come and invested well to help bring the light. But too few have chosen to stay, and as a result, much of rural Alaska has been over-evangelized, but under-discipled.
This narrative is changing through Marketplace Ministry. This is simply ordinary people like me getting secular jobs that allow us to live missionally amongst the people. As we plant house churches and discipleship communities in villages all over the Yukon and Kuskokwim River Delta, we need to keep the movement unified and members of my team resourced. This is impossible to do from our current training center, which is over 500 miles away. As this movement expands, we need a hub that is strategically located in order to be accessible for those of us on the ground.
Last year, through a local network partnership, God miraculously provided a solution to this need, a church building in the YK Delta village of Bethel, Alaska. Bethel is one of the most strategic hubs for rural ministry in our state, as it services close to half of the villages which are on that list of 100 without a consistent gospel witness. We envision that this will be a church for the community of Bethel, but also a regional center serving the needs of a network of village discipleship communities. The 7,000 square foot building has loads of potential, but a lot of problems.
We will need to reconfigure and remodel for the building to operate as the first of several hubs that will become launch pads for marketplace movements in all areas of Alaska. That's why we are calling this our Hub One initiative, a hub for training future marketplace ministers, a hub for resourcing the teams on the ground, and a hub for equipping future indigenous disciple makers.
This is not just an investment in one building, but an entire region. We see this opportunity as a critical juncture for rural Alaskan ministry, a time in history for the church that could help change the tide of the story.
What has happened in the last several years is nothing short of a miracle. We've been able to push back on the darkness. We've seen 26 men and women say yes to carrying the light to rural Alaska, and more workers are on the way. We must steward this miracle. We will prepare to equip the called. We can become a movement that is sustainable and not here today and gone tomorrow. All of this makes our Hub One initiative timely and critical.
There's a whisper that has echoed through the ages of the church and the people of God since the time of Jesus, and that whisper is God's command to go and make disciples of all nations. At Evangel, the way that we fulfill God's command to go is through legacy makers. It's people giving generously or going generously in reaching the world with the message of Jesus outside the four walls of the church. We do that through five different lanes of giving and going. It's care for vulnerable kids through things like the Lily Initiative and assisting foster and adoptive families. It's local missions with things like Hub One and reaching the most rural parts of Alaska. It's global missions and our partnerships to take the Bible literally and translate it into languages that have never heard it before. It's future leaders and MLC, the next generation of pastors and leaders for God's church, and its future projects, its campuses, and other places where we can develop the church, where people will hear the message of Jesus. And this year, we're believing God for $2.5 million to make all five of these lanes happen through Legacy Makers, so that we can hear the stories and understand what God is doing all around the world by taking the message of Jesus to the ends of the earth until every nation and tribe and tongue has heard about what he's done for them.
Never seen such an authentic seriousness for people wanting to change their lives and give their life to Christ. God is doing something. He's prepping the ground like I've never seen. People aren't trying to impress us when we come in there. They're just trying to surrender their lives to Jesus. People behind bars love your church. And people who have lost hope find hope in Jesus through watching your services. And your church prayed with them and discipled them. I just love how you bring the gospel into places and gave them Jesus when they felt forgotten.